Protesters marching for Vanessa Guillen, the missing Fort Hood soldier. Her family believes that remains recently found in a shallow grave are hers. ABC's Stephanie Ramos has more on the protesters' demands. Good morning, Stephanie.
Eva, good morning. Protesters demanded justice for Vanessa Guillen. Her family spent the past week in Washington, D.C., pushing a congressional investigation into Vanessa's disappearance, rushing back to Houston, Texas, Saturday to march for Vanessa with the support from their hometown.
Overnight, hundreds marching to Houston's City Hall, demanding justice for Army soldier Vanessa Guillen. Vanessa was last seen April 22nd, just before noon, outside of her barracks on one of the country's largest military installations in Killeen, Fort Hood. The 20-year-old's family says Vanessa told them she was being sexually harassed by a soldier before her disappearance and didn't tell her superiors for fear of retribution. Now, authorities say a fellow soldier killed her.
We need the congressional investigation. I'm not just going to stay grieving in my room because I know Vanessa wouldn't want that. She wants justice.
This week, investigators found unidentified human remains about 20 miles from the post. The Army hasn't identified them, but Guillen's family believes it's her.
She was mutilated because of sexual harassment and sexual assault, because we don't have a system in place that will provide for a woman like that to go and report.
20-year-old Army Specialist Aaron Robinson was identified as the suspect in Guillen's case. Robinson died by suicide when authorities made contact with him on Wednesday, according to the Army's Criminal Investigation Command. Authorities say Robinson's girlfriend, 22-year-old Cecily Aguilar, told investigators he asked her to help hide Guillen's body. Aguilar has been charged with one count of conspiracy to tamper with evidence. For months, Guillen's family claims the Army did not take her disappearance seriously.
What I was able to share was tempered by my responsibility to protect the integrity of the investigation so that we could find Vanessa, B, prosecute those responsible for this travesty, and in the end be in a position to punish them. And I just wish I could have done a better job balancing those two needs.
Suspect Cecily Aguilar has her first court appearance tomorrow. Vanessa Guillen's family is also pushing for legislation that would provide a third-party agency for soldiers who are victims of sexual harassment or assault instead of reporting incidents to the designated victim's advocate, who is usually a colleague within the same unit. Dan.
Stephanie, thank you so much. It's a case that has aroused so many strong feelings and shines a light on some really powerful and important issues, so we will continue to cover it.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.